Tomorrow, November 18th, 2023, will mark 3 years ever since over 50 people were hit dead by stray bullets during the violent demonstrations which were triggered when security forces arrested the then National Unity Platform Party presidential candidate Robert Kyagulanyi in the Eastern Luuka district for allegedly flouting the COVID-19 prevention rules. This morning, during an engagement with the human rights defenders, security and officials from the Ministry of Justice in Kampala, the Uganda Law Society has launched a new report finding dubbed Rule of Law, where they demand justice for victims of human rights abuses and also bring to book the perpetrators of the human rights violations.
But I think the bigger question is, we need to hold the perpetrators accountable, because without accountability, it continues. It then becomes impunity. So while we are here, we believe that instead of going to the street to protest as Uganda Law Society, we can engage constructively.
The president of the Uganda Law Society, Bernard Oundo, says government should take the initiative to see that the victims and families of the November 2020 killings are compensated.
They know who was killed. They must take the initiative. That is the good, that is the better way to do it. They should take the initiative because government has accepted. And they are saying that, yes, we know that some people were unlawfully killed. If you know that they are unlawfully killed, then you should take the initiative to find these people and compensate them.
The founder and the executive director of the Foundation for Human Rights Initiative, Dr. Livingstone Sewanyana, says in order not to undermine the principle of applying fairness, the government should evaluate all those who lost their loved ones during the November 2020 riots and urgently compensate them.
The state must call upon all those who lost their families and evaluate that and be able to provide them with the compensation. And that compensation must not only be adequate, must be timely. If it is not timely, then it also undermines the principle that fairness is not being achieved.
The Justice Minister, Norbert Mao, advised the families of the victims to engage the concerned government authorities rather than ganging up with opposition leaders to castigate the government.
But these victims have families. I don't think they should put their faith in the political parties that are pretending to be speaking for them. I think they need to organize themselves and demand. The people like Sewanyana's parents did not work through a political party to come to me. Segirinya's mother did not work through a political party to come to me. She came directly. So I believe that these families also need to exercise that level of vigilance.
On the issue of National Unity Platform missing persons, he noted that there should be a legal process and the Office of the Attorney General would be happy to have a serious discussion on that basis rather than drama from the opposition MPs.
The state is always being tackled by organized citizens. So there should be a legal process, and I'm sure the Office of the Attorney General would be happy to have a serious discussion on that basis. But instead, all we have is drama. All we have is demonization.
Security operatives from the Uganda People's Defense Forces gave confidence to the public that security agencies against human rights will always be punished.
If I have made a mistake, you can arrest me. But I think there is a better way to arrest me. You don't find a soldier armed like what we saw in Kayunga, and you attempt to arrest him in that aggressive way. I think there is a more civil way you can actually even arrest me. And we have arrested our soldiers on orders of the civilian population.
Report by Jaliat Namwaya for the news.